Okay, friends, this is the holidays, and I'm sure you're enjoying yourself, and I'm hoping you are having a good one, and I want to say Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, God bless you. I hope all is well with you, and you're spending much time with your family. You're contemplating the Jesus, and he's on your mind much more than his birth, but you're also thinking about his life and his crucifixion and resurrection as well. Now, friends, we got a good one for you today. This is Humphrey once again. We're going to be sharing another one. They're going to bless our hearts today. So Humphrey, the title of this one, Angels We Have Heard on High. All right, I thought this will be a good one, a little Christmas feel here, leaving you a little something to think about. I love me some Humphrey. These guys are awesome. Anyway, make sure you like and subscribe to the page. Click the bell icon for more of our notification upload. Comment below, share a thought perspective with me. Without further ado, let us now get into the heart of the message. All right, let's do it.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plain.
Angels we singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Everybody, thanks for watching our video of Angels We Have Heard on High. Yeah. Really excited to do that song. Fun choral arrangement for us, a little different from normal.
So and weird. Adam got to sing, y'all.
Well, heck yeah,
I sang on that one too.
Special thank you to the Sisters of Notre Dame for letting us film there again. Really love that space. Really awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And get our Christmas album Full of Cheer if you haven't already.
Do it.
Come see us on tour.
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody. Bye.
Bye.
I love me some Humphrey, man. These guys are amazing. How did you enjoy the show? That was just beautiful. All around beautiful. Yeah, that's how I feel. Exceptionally amazing. You know, the story of Jesus certainly is one that we must contemplate upon, not just during Christmas season, but all the time. There is something amazing about that story when it is carefully studied. One thing for certain is that Jesus did come. Now, we can argue. Was it on December 25th? The answer is no, he wasn't. Okay, let's be honest. But that doesn't necessarily mean we need to destroy the spirit of the season because of that either. Because there's something special about Christmas, regardless of the fact that we know Christ didn't show up exactly on Christmas Day. There's a whole nother study behind that. So we can save that for another discussion if you want to know. But one thing for certain is that he did come. He did live. He did die. And he also resurrected. He also ascended to heaven. He is alive and well. And the Bible says God has given him a name that is above every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. That's the good news of the gospel, my dear friends, that I'm hoping you are enjoying this season. I got one text, though. The Christ who came, we are told in Scripture, is coming again. He came one time to die for sins. But did you know that he's coming again to take us home? We are told, my dear friends, for all of you who believe in Jesus Christ, don't ever let this hope depart from your heart. So Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many. And unto them that appear for him, and unto them that look for him, shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. In essence, Jesus who left is coming again. So he came one time to die for sins. Friends, the purpose of Christ's coming was to die for the sins of the world. And all those who believe and repent shall be saved. But he is coming again. Aren't you glad to know that Jesus is coming again? Trouble won't last always. This crazy world of ours. I am so thankful to know that there is coming a time when pain and sorrows shall be no more. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me, and in my Father's house so many mansions. If we're not so, I would have told you, I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and to receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. How do I get there? Jesus says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh to the Father but except by me. So, my dear friends, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, God bless you. Enjoy yourself, spend some time with those ones you love. That's what I'm about to do. I'm going upstairs to spend some time with the family. We have a house party going on here. just cherishing the ones you love, especially during this season, and those who may not have someone to love upon them. How about we take the time to do that? We've selected a family to do this with. There are some today during this season who are experiencing a lot of pain. So draw near to them as well. I just want to wish you a happy holidays, Merry Christmas. God bless you all. I'm hoping all is well with you. I'm praying that the blessing of the Lord will order your life and sustain you as well. Continue to be strong. Continue to believe. And continue to aim for your goals. Don't ever stop. Know that the presence of God is with you. As long as you have faith in Him, you have no reason to fear. Until next time, and as always, friends, remember to look unto Jesus and to live by faith. Have a good one. Bye.